Pagurumba, woman, they are Japan, in the mood, yeah, very mood, and with Patiment, yeah, Jaika.
Boma, Nava Jaika, Nitoko Zamanin, you could ya, but Pasako win of pan.
Ah, nobody's like,
Reduced agriculture production and productivity in our country has been a challenge in the sector. This low productivity has been caused by a number of factors, some of them being poor management practices by the farmers and, to the larger extent, climate change. The Minister of Agriculture and Livestock is charged with the responsibility to promote appropriate technologies that can enhance production among local farmers in the country.
The government is committed to providing a conducive environment for the growth of the agricultural sector through the provision of extension services as its mandate.
In enhancing production and productivity, the ministry uses a variety of recommended technologies and promotes sustainable management practices among the local farmers. Some of the technologies that the Ministry of Agriculture and Livestock provide to farmers come with incentives in terms of money or material support.
Nalibe ngombe komalero lino naona ko bwino. Nilimisa munda na ngombe, nitumshisha mili singolo na ngombe. Nalibepo kuti penango ningachetekele nipunzi savana kambaka kuti napezamo ubwino mchitukuko chatu ichi.
Kugaishira pano pafupi, tigaishira pano pafupi, so vambiri kupyorera mu cooperative vitapezamo ubwino.
The Japanese government, through participatory village development approach in isolated areas, PAVIDIA has been working with the Minister of Agriculture and Livestock to support farmers living in far-flung areas such as villages.
Yes, they are very active and very good. And our volunteer, Japanese volunteer, can't live in the rural area without Zambian farmers.
Rural farmers are kind of the power for the national development, and also we believe that the equality of the progressive economic development. Now you can see those of the village development was brought by the collaboration of Ministry of Agriculture and JICA.
Currently, about 500 villages, including 250,000 people in rural areas, have adopted the PAVIDIA approach by starting micro projects.
Since 2002, JICA has been working with the Ministry of Agriculture and Livestock in supporting villages using a participatory development approach named PAVIDIA. The approach was invented by JICA experts Dr. Hikaru Niki and his Zambian counterparts in 2002. Currently, 500 villages, including 250,000 people in rural areas, have adopted this PAVIDIA approach. The approach is to provide funding to a village and villagers start micro projects with support from extension officers. This approach has been working very good since it directly helps the rural villagers and the impact is tangible.
The approach is that funding is provided to a village and the villagers start micro projects with support from agriculture extension officers. Consequently, through using improved technologies such as animal draft power, as opposed to using hose, some villagers have improved their livelihood by having better housing and are able to take their children to school.
Nzuatu wenze puwa maningi kusiana na minzi yonse. So kuwela kwa chituku kwa mzuwa suwaoneka buino. Manganda mala ata paka wana tapunzisa, stenze punzisa wana kupiolela mchituku uko. Chinawela cha ngombe pano. So ine natenga ngombe inabala mwana wa festi. Inabala mkazi roni inabweza kuparetiva. Pafuti inabala winango mwana mkazi soni na ngombe ziviri. Zauti sinenze embe kezea tininga nkale na ngombe. Nankala nazo kupiolela muliwa jika na boma.
Chisowe village of Luangwa district is an example of a village that has improved the standard of living through micro projects. Ministry of Agriculture and Livestock, in collaboration with Japanese International Cooperation Agency JICA, through participatory approach to sustainable village development, PASFID, provided seed money to farmers for them to purchase cattle and a hammer mill.
Tiami kila kopo sa chifuwa tigenzi lakuti kusogoro kukale manyumba mwatu muno kapena mkopeti vyatu yaoneka ya sinta. Mambili tangana manyumba ya marata kuchoka wameti na manyumba ya mauzu. Kale kakali idweka mwakala kabwino chifuwa chikuti tatandisi kakopo sa. Ndipo tingo ya mpikezi lakuti kusogoro kuku tizapiti lirapa.
The farmers have also given a heifer to each family under the program as a way of empowering households. The program is such that when cattle calves down, the calf is taken back as a loan repayment.
Tikapasa ngombe, mwana wa namba 1, aina kusaha mkopaitiwa. Tikabala namba 2, nyepo chosa mwana na nyawe ya chosa pamoja. So, tinapata futi namba 2, tinapasa futi, tinapasa same, tinapasa futi 20. So, hapa, tinapasa waja, ngombe za namba 1 ya mene mwana, ama sawa futi mkopaitiwa. Zabana utupasa waja, ikabala mwana usaha mkopaitiwa, kima pasa futi wena, wena futi ikabala futi, pasa wena, so unolendo kuna sawa 21.
Stephen Nyangu is a member of Chisowe Village who is one of the beneficiaries to this program.
Kuyamba meti na amba chitu kukwechi, pamini wana tandiza wa boma, kulingana na umpaya wa meti nao. Tikuona kuti tikupindula kwa mbili. Chifuwa, pameti na hii kumbuyo ku, tiyarewa ufutikila mjaza mbili, mani midwe, anani kutifuta. Tiyari kukulola pangono, chifuwa chakuti kulima kwa manja, kunari kufuta. Kwa maningi ni boma mena tandiza, tiyami kila chifuwa tankana zoli mila za mbili, mangazi wetu za mezi tandiza kulima munda. Ndiponso potuta, tinale kufutika kunyamula pa mutu. So, fwata zwetu zimenezi, titutula so na zikochikari.
Ideally, these interventions by PAVIDIA are provided in the villages to improve the targeted community's lives.
Kusogoro kuno kamene tandandamika zintu, tiembekezera kuti tifuna kuti chira nyumba papezeke mwana aliyense amene azaenda kusukulu kapena kunkhalako na mapunzira pamwamba. Ndiponso ngakhale ulimi tifuna kuti tizikwanisa kapena kugulisako kuboma chifuwa malimidwe athu yaonika kuti yankhala yao savuta chifuwa timalima na ziweto. Ndipo kumbali ya kutukula futi tiganiza tu tiguleso futi kapena mberere zimene tinazo kati tinagulirapo matifuna kuti tiziwonjezereke nazo kusogolaka futi tikapasane futi kuti aliyense akapeze mophindu.
In Zalapango village of Luangwa district, a beneficiary from the micro projects had this to share.
Mbambe kudala ichichigayo, munga makambira kare, kuti tenzepesa kubwina. So I group itina werapo manje, uroti werapo, but vintu sivenze enda bwina. Uroti titenga isempando, nishi before nisha, chaonungeka kudala.
As you can rightly see that there's a remarkable difference between the two villages that we have just from visiting. That village and this one. From this one you could see that they've managed to improve their welfare in terms of the number of animals they have from 15 to a record high of about 86 amongst a group. And you could see the animals, they look very healthy. And this has really improved their livelihood in terms of provision of income for them to pay their school fees and also for them to transport their farm produce and for them to transport their inputs to their homestead. So really their livelihood has been remarkably improved. And also they have a hammer mill which they use to mill their grain. So you could see that they don't have to travel long distances, which are the women folk. And as such, they have time for them to do other productive ventures on their farm.
At the nutrition village in Kafue district, it was noted that farmers were excited and more interested in the micro projects to an extent where some have adopted fish farming.
Welcome from Zambia this morning.
Welcome. You understand me.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Welcome in Zambia. Yeah. Welcome, Mr. Ono. Ah, Mr. Ono.
Under the JICA projects, we have the fish ponds where the farmers are trying to keep fish. This is the third time they are stocking, and from the start, they started with 600 fingerlings. They went to 1,200, and as at now, they stocked about 1,850. This just shows you how this project is improving with time. From the stocks themselves, you can tell that the farmers are growing.
Kafue Nutrition Settlement Scheme was founded in 1972 by our former Republican President, Dr. Kenneth Kaunda. We are mostly involved in vegetable production, poultry keeping, and of late we have started fish farming, a project which was funded by JICA, working in collaboration with the government of the Republic of Zambia through the Ministry of Agriculture. We started the nutrition fish project in 2010, October. The first batch was done, and now we are doing our third batch.
Nondi pagurumba go uhulumende ya Japan winda mu by my department, yeah, JICA. It will hold to Kahili, Magana, and Bulimbo, they will soon pull up a caribou, so move Hubanswe. So I wobble a Bataira, Abasuman, and the way we am better go to Kahili here. Hinji, Hiji, and the Ganagan Bouti to Kahigan and Mogatabu caribou.
There could be no doubt that some villages are receptive to new technologies while others are not.
You notice that we have three farmers who have adopted this technology. This technology was, we were able to bring these new technologies to these farmers by the help of JICA. We had a volunteer by the name of Ono who assisted us in the digging of the fish ponds and also in the trainings on fish farming. And from that, we had three farmers who adopted the technology. And as at now, one farmer has already stopped. Then the two other farmers, they've just dug the fish ponds. They are yet to stop.
I'm a Japanese volunteer. I came from Japan. So I work with farmer and my fellow worker. They coming from Cafe District Agriculture Office. We supported fish farming project and the pottery project and the gardening project. So I just support them, not work only me. Working together. Management is very important. So planning, so before starting is very important. So what kind of material do we need and what kind of input. Yeah. So first planning, then on the planning we success.
Some villages do not have capacity to utilize the resources to good use.
Monga masiku ano, kamila kati dira futi ndra. Tingakule spare part mbuna tagulira ako. Kutimanya kuti kapikinge. Kuti ndama ibwere. Si bwera. Utapeta 2 or 3 days. Kana break it down ifu.
Evinto bankala maningi. So lo hapa ufaka ondramba biva ni bichitika because za pesika tu jioni kamunga mpasi yabo jana seriza jana. Mathendi yakwana then na inotayo yantili mu season nili skulibe kwambili. So ipa pesika kuti olo vantu vagaisa nije tumiri stokula chema market so profit enene nkala kulibe.
It should be understood that capacity development of villages is important. It is for this reason that Minister of Agriculture and Livestock, in collaboration with Japanese International Cooperation Agency JICA, organized a workshop for senior agriculture officers in Lusaka province to build capacity among senior staff so that it can filter down to the village setup through the extension officers.
That senior management meeting that or workshop that was conducted last month at Kaunga Farmers Training Center in Iruangwa has assisted ourselves. And you know, the aim of that training was to improve on the management skills in as far as extension service delivery is concerned to our senior agriculture officers in our 8 districts. I'm sure you are aware that as Lusaka province, we now have 8 districts. So all our senior agriculture officers were in attendance. And in addition to that, we invited also our extension methodologists. All the 8 were present. This was to make sure that both the SAO and our extension methodologists get the same information. All what it is that we want to improve extension management skills of our officers at the district level.
The Ministry of Agriculture and Livestock has 1,700 extension officers dotted all over the country who live near to the farmers. It is the duty of the senior agriculture officers to monitor and supervise extension officers.
The Department of Agriculture is not only the largest, but it is one with the graviest functions, if you like. I always want to put it that way. It's the backbone of the Ministry of Agriculture. The senior agriculture officer is the head of this department at the district level. And the extension methodologist is the head of the advisory and food nutrition section at the district level, advising the whole ministry in as far as dissemination methods are concerned.
For farmers to utilize resources properly, they need suitable information and guidance from the extension staff for them to accurately implement various technologies being introduced to the farmers. Zalapango village of Luangwa district is one type of a village that could not put the resources provided to them to good use.
The concept of seed money, provision of seed money to enhance rural development amongst the community is a very good concept which our partners JICA provided some years back to these rural communities. Yes, we have seen some projects have been doing well, some projects seemingly they haven't been doing very well. But I think the problem also lies within the very communities themselves. There was a need to over time change leadership, and also the leadership that comes in carries on the vision which the initial leadership was with. So that disturbed the sustainability of these very important income generating activities.
So this Zarapango village that was founded through the Ministry of Culture, and they started the community activities here. And I came here the first time in 2005, and at that time this village was very, very active. Then now you can see that there's kind of this active activity is getting a bit slow. I think this is one, you know, phenomenon of that rural development. It's very, very dynamic. You can't foresee what it's going to be like, you know, after 10 years later. But the point is that continuous monitoring is really key for success. This is why that we JICA, we support the Ministry of Agriculture.
Apart from assisting the rural communities, JICA has also helped the Ministry of Agriculture and Livestock to upgrade its structures. Kaunga Farmer Training Center is one of the institutions that benefited through JICA funding to improve the center. The center was built to train farmers in income-generating activities and to grow early-maturing crops because the area is prone to drought.
The rainfall pattern is quite unpredictable. Yeah, at this center we have two dormitories with bed spaces of about 30-32. We are using solar lighting here because we are avoiding to continuously using the genset because diesel fuel is very expensive. So we are using solar to provide lighting. Yeah, we just use the diesel at times, mostly to power the borehole, to pump water for irrigation and for other domestic purposes. Yeah, so we're really conducting a lot of trainings here. We also do some IGAs, income generating activities. We are doing broiler production, and also we are planning to start doing goat production and village chicken production.
JICA Risk Up Feedback Advisor Takahiro Miyoshi noted that targeting village features is more sustainable than cooperatives, which is more of an artificial feature. He pointed out that technical support is necessary for sustainability of projects for farmers.
Sometimes the village development is very dynamic. Sometimes they confront some challenges. At that time, they need some support from outside, the technical support. So I actually confirmed that our approach is right because we are supporting the extension system to support the rural farmers to sustain their development.
The partnership of the Zambian government and the Japanese government has changed the lives of small-scale farmers through the use of improved technologies in the country.
It is easier to push people out of poverty by increasing their asset base, because using the assets, they should be able to plan for their future and decide on what it is they can do to make the first step out of poverty.
Indeed, the fruits are there to show that the company between Zambia and Japan is a good company, because the friendship has empowered many lives in Zambia's rural areas.
Japan has also rural areas where people depend on their lives in agriculture, livestock and fisheries. And Japan achieved the economic development with keeping some equity between urban and rural areas. It is inclusive development. And Japanese have a lot of experience in rural development, which can be shared with Zambian people.
Nalipa loan. So nakwanisa kulipa loan within 4 years, na si zam 1986. Intasiji za mlandwa chituko kuenda pasogolo, na kuwe na plani ina watu banja ya kula. So ni maki nyumba inango mpamene na manga nyumba inango. Kupita kwa masiku mlandwa chituko, mwana wanga die futa na manga so hiyo nyumba hiyo. Patika kupiti zabe kumanga manyumba inango. Patiku sogolo atisi kwenye nkara malo, yosu ngilamu wa lendo, ajibanja, niwe na wache vanga soe malo kapena wafuna renti, zizita kugwiza na nao kuno kuno.
Ya kuwapa sa, kakudia, kukudisa, kupena kuwapa sa jabu. Kururu.